I'm Brian Westbrook at AWS Summit New York City, joined by our friends at DoiT. You have some exciting things going on. I want to introduce Eduardo Mota, Senior Cloud Data Architect, and Arri Rucker, Regional Director of Client Services America. Thank you for joining us. I want to get right to it. What excites you most about generative AI? Lots of discussion here at this summit about generative AI. And where is it headed?
I mean, it's so exciting, the fast innovation that is going on in the space. So many things are changing. We just heard a bunch of new services coming out. And for me, where it's going and the exciting part is this collaboration that we have with the expertise of human and Gen AI to be able to really unlock what we are capable of doing. So the possibilities are out there. The possibilities are amazing, and that's what I'm really excited about, exploring all those possibilities with Gen AI right now.
Lots of great things going on. Customers are using Gen AI to influence their buying decisions. Arri, why don't you tell us a little bit about how the customers are using Gen AI?
Yeah, so it first starts is where is the data and where are the services located and available in the regions that they're using, and then based on the use case, which technologies they select, and then overall, what will it cost? A lot of the use cases that we're seeing is to augment the workforce, driving automated insights. So there's a number of industry vertical use cases that we're evaluating, whether it's in manufacturing, financial services, retail, where it makes the work that they're doing more efficient and more effective.
Now, AWS and DoiT are working very closely to collaborate to solve some of these challenges. Why don't you tell me a little bit more about some of these examples?
Yeah, absolutely. We have, for example, in the manufacturing industry, being able to get insights about time series data and be able to leverage Bedrock, great models that are available in Bedrock to get insights from this data, right? We have in the retail, we have in the hospitality industry as well, right? For example, being able to use menus from restaurants and then give a personalized experience to end users where they can order food, make changes, have their dietary restrictions, and be able, the LLM, be able to remember what they have, what their profile is, and then make recommendations later on, so to make the whole experience a lot better, right? On the financial institution side of things, being able to really deep dive into the personalization of the transactions, what those transactions can tell you, and then be able to drive behavior from that. So those are very exciting. And we are on all of these is connecting the data that already companies have with Bedrock and LLMs, and then really unlocking all of that potential of the information available in them.
It sounds like really fascinating stuff. Do you ever wake up and just say, what's going on? What's happening? Like, how do you keep all this? How do you keep track of all this?
Absolutely. It's difficult sometimes to be able to keep up with everything. But when we are working with customers day in and day out and be able to face the challenges, that's what keeps it exciting, right? Keeps it fresh. You're always diving into this, always finding new ways of exploring and making solutions for our customers. And ultimately, it's a continuous learning that we go through on a daily basis with our customers and our partners and within DoiT, right? So it's exciting.
Arri, I want to ask you, explain FinOps and why companies should be concerned and be using best practices in that space.
Yeah, I think the core value of adopting FinOps practices is to bring everyone together, right? So it's not the finance department managing costs without the visibility of the developers and the engineering team understanding the impact. It's really connecting it all across the board. So we know that every dollar that we're spending on the cloud is connected to business value and ROI.
And it's easy to lose track of that. It's easy to say, let's build this great cloud solution. But if the FinOps isn't there, if the dollars and cents don't make, if you'll pardon the expression, sense, it sort of falls apart. You're not really putting it together. How, as an architect, do you find watching how the transactions are going through really makes business sense?
Yeah, I mean, from the beginning, right? When we are starting the ideation phase, we start looking at how does this make sense to the business and start having those conversations. As we move through the phases and get into production, it's important to keep track of that. The observability of the entire workload is important and be able to understand how much things are costing. And at DoiT, we are definitely hyper-focused on FinOps. And so that includes Gen AI, the tokens, how many tokens, how do we optimize the prompts, how we optimize the data retention, and then from there, being able to really drive that ROI for the customers.
Fantastic conversation. Thank you so much for your time, Eduardo, Arri. I'm Brian Westbrook here at AWS Summit New York City. Thanks for watching.